What's up, yo? What's up, yo? It's your boy, Rich Tyresh, back with a kind of lengthy video. What I want to do is I want to show a couple games, not really a couple, probably like 8, 20 different purposes excited for. When they come out, I got all the video. It's going to be like a two-part series, or a two-part video, where me playing the games I want to see come out. Going to come out, but I'm highly anticipated about it. Gonna be, I think today we're gonna do like 7. I'm gonna do the rest gonna do first person games that's coming out, and I want to show y'all. A lot of people don't know what the games are, so I'm gonna show you on I'm watching basically 7 trips of the different games that I'm excited for. A lot of people know I play first-person shooter. That's my kind of thing I do on a channel. Sometimes I do fighting game, stuff like that. But it's mostly just first-person shooter. What we're gonna do is gonna my screen. Let's get it.
Everyone, we're excited to be here, excited to talk about Payday, and excited to be working with Prime Matter. At Starbreeze, we see Payday as the ultimate bank robbing experience, inspired by classic heist movies, providing adrenaline-fueled gameplay where you get to experience the thrill of being on the wrong side of the law with a smart plan and a gun in your hand. This is what we've been doing since the original game, Payday the Heist, through the sequel, Payday 2, to the upcoming Payday 3. And our ever-growing player community, our heisters, continue to be an inspiration for us in everything we do, pushing us to make the best Payday possible. Payday is an exaggerated reflection of reality where order is kept by the long arm of the law. At least until the heisters turn this order into chaos, giving the law the middle finger. That's when adrenaline truly kicks in and the outnumbered gang keeps beating the odds, often escaping with the cash in a hail of bullets. The Payday universe has an ongoing narrative that has been created over the years. The gang has built a reputation by going after the highest profile targets, setting up some of the craziest heist plans, and going up against some of the most powerful of enemies. And through all of this, the gang keeps coming out on top. In their exploits, the gang has become, as they call it, the tightest crew ever. The wider criminal underworld of Payday lives its own life, where movers and shakers want a piece of the action, or a piece of the Payday gang. In the gang's life of crime, they are way past the point of no return, and as we look ahead for what's to come, the gang will learn that there's no rest for the wicked. This legacy is something that we treasure and will build on, expanding on this epic story, taking you all with us into the future of Payday. Many millions of players have enjoyed Payday so far. It's been an amazing journey for us at Starbreeze. On Steam, Payday 2 has the biggest player community of any game. This truly means the world to us. Payday turns 10 this year, but we're only getting started. With our team hard at work, cooperation with Prime Matter and other partners, and above all, a fantastic player community, we are looking to the future with great anticipation.
I'm rich! It's Payday, fellas!
The release of Payday 3 is years away, but we could finish off today with a sneak peek of what we're working on, a taste of things to come.
Yeah, that's it for Payday 3. I played the first one and the second one. I like those games, really. It kind of had like a Left 4 Dead or Back 4 Blood kind of style. So usually pick a weapon on the ground, have it highlighted and stuff. I played all of them. Fun game. I loved them. So let's go to the next game. Next game is going to Tiny Tina's Wonderland. Let's get into it right now. Well, yeah, that's one of the games I'm looking forward to also. Big fan of the Borderlands. I could say a spinoff, but owned standalone. And it'll be good, bro. It's going to look good. I have played all the Borderlands except for the very last one. Last one. I watched a lot of gameplay on it. But anyway, I love Borderlands. Creation is going. Now, next to the next game, watch the Outer Worlds 2 trailer. Outer Worlds 2 trailer, and we're gonna see what's in store.
We begin by hearing an old, wise sounding voice, and we see a quiet, peaceful setting. This will make our game seem big and important. Now, something must break the serenity. Will this creature be in the game? No. Say goodbye to it forever. Suddenly, and for no reason, people running. These pointless slow-motion shots make everything seem cool and should bolster pre-sale numbers. That wah sound can mean only one thing. We must gaze over an epic shot of a world. And there should be lens flares. Now we see our hero. But only their silhouette, because the developers haven't finished the design. Or finished the story. Or finished any gameplay that's actually ready to show. In fact, the only thing they have finished is the title.
All right, yes, that's Outer World 2. I played the first one. I enjoyed the first one. Like I say, it's a first. I enjoyed it, you know. But, you know, one of the games I'm about to play. This game. The next game, Redfall, for Xbox. Xbox is clear. Look, I think it's coming out next year. So I'm going to get it D1.
Thank you.
is two tangible 25 centimeters dramatically elongated mass.
Come on, make yourself useful.
So, that was fun, right?
That's your cue, mate!
Sleep tight.
You know what this reminds me of? My time in the Himalayas.
Ready is later, Dad.
You think they can't kill you anytime they want?
Hey, asshole!
Sun's coming up. Let's keep moving.
Let's keep moving.
Sure thing, Edgar Allan Bro.
That's a good one.
Do you think things will ever go back to normal?
Would you want to go back to normal?
Not if I still have to pay my student loans.
Okay, that's Redfall, official, official trailer. I'm excited for this game. I want to know how this game gonna be. Now that it's looks like it's gonna be co-op. What Microsoft is always used to do, like have games that's come with like co-op. For always something like they always have that type of game that comes. Where's Gears? Where's Back for Blood or Left for Dead. But anyway, I like Redfall. I seen it. I'm getting it day one. I mean, get on Game Pass. I think I don't know if some of the games gonna be on Game Pass. I don't know particularly if it's Game Pass, but I'm definitely sure I'm gonna play it. I have an Xbox Series X, so I'm good on consoles. I also got an Xbox One. I got I play Xbox games on or Game Pass. That's beside the point. But anyway, this is a good game. I love Redfall. I want to be story. I want to see what happened, how it started, all that stuff. So next game is going to be Far Cry 6. Let's watch it. Graphic look good already. And I'm watching it in 4K. Y'all probably gonna see it in 1080p.
Guapo, you listen. Rule 16. The Guerrero's revolution never ends. Always another war, another cantina, another ugly bartender.
Juan Cortez?
What do you think gave it away, Guapo?
This is a fucking waste of time.
Can you whistle?
What?
Nah, you can't whistle. Not bad, Danny, but we're just getting started. Rule number one, a good guerrilla is a hidden guerrilla.
Puerto El Perro, se acabó la rabia.
We lead our operations in secret camps across the country. Here, guerrillas live,
kaboom!
Train, and plan.
Small pack. We go in, grab our people, kill whoever gets in our way.
By smuggling in supplies, we'll add some piss and fire to our movement.
You got that right.
Camp chef, black market dealers, these safe havens got everything a guerrilla needs. Even do-it-yourself vehicles. You're gonna love it, Danny. Rule number two. A good guerrilla masters their environment. This land is your home, Danny. I'm sure you know every inch of it. From the bloodthirsty jungles, postcard shorelines, the dead-end towns, and our friendly capital city. How you get around is up to you. If you want to play it safe, take our secret paths carved in the dirt of old revolutions.
Hola, Danny.
How you doing?
Or take a risk and operate in plain sight of Castillo's assholes.
Man, this graphics off the chain in the customers. Man, this graphics off.
What do you got?
No, we can play this. D1, PS4, I mean PS5. D1.
You always need to be a loudmouth, Danny.
Christmas trees? Do we even grow those here?
Mexicans pay crazy money for this. How you think El Presidente funded Maria's new face?
Okay. Go through.
Rule number three. Fucked up situations call for fucked up solutions.
Hey, he's not here.
You expect the reinforcements? I got news for you. You're an army of one against an army of thousands. When shit gets real, we make use of whatever we have. We call that resolver. That means absolutely everything from sardine cans, goddamn batteries, to old motorcycle engines have been built into equipment.
Right. Guns like it is built from scrap metal, but it looks unique to the gameplay. So, company or games that usually have these type of weapons, a customized weapons, either be like Resistant or Ratchet and Clank. When the Insomniac do their game, they have weapons just like that, randomized. Wolfenstein, those type of shooting games, they have that customization and the unique likeness of how the weapons look. I really gonna get this game. I like how it looks. I'm watching in 4K, by the way. I got a 4K monitor and stuff like that, so I'm playing in 4K 60 frames. So this game is gonna be good. It's gonna be good.
It's fun.
Oh, and the final rule: a good guerrilla always brings a friend along for moral support.
All right, that's it for Far Cry 6. I'm getting day one. PS5. I'm getting day one. And then hopefully I get my friends get it too. I don't know if it's co-op. I don't know if it's just single player. But I'm getting it, no matter what. I played every single last Far Cry. I enjoyed them all. This gonna be, I like the environment, how big the map's gonna be. I know it's gonna be a real good game. Got one of the greatest actors out right now, and he's on multiple TV or other video games also. So this is gonna be a good game. I'm getting it day one. No ifs, buts, ands about none of that. Getting day one. Let's go to the next video. Next video is gonna be Dying Light 2. Dying Light 2. Now, Dying Light 2, I beat Dying Light 1 maybe like 3 days, 2 or 3 days after the release. I played the hell out of Dying Light. I beat it. I like the parkour. I like the zombies, stuff like that. It's cool fun. I enjoyed it a lot. But let's get into the video. Let's see what's so fucking wild too. Make any videos or let us know about the gameplay. Check it out.
Hey everyone, we've been quiet for some time since, like the rest of the world, we had some unforeseen hurdles to clear. But the wait is over. Let's dive into the open world of Dying Light 2. The last slice of Dying Light 2 showcased the mission from the main storyline.
You get out of those, fuck.
You saw how your decisions influenced the narrative and notably changed the environment. This time, we want to give you a broader look at the game and a sneak peek at some of the things we'll be talking about in upcoming months. Dying Light 2, you become Aiden Caldwell, an outsider trying to unravel a tangled mystery from his past. Its trail leads him to the city, probably the last bastion of mankind in the world.
Shit!
At first, you feel like this intense, brutal place will tear you apart. But then you meet the Night Runners, veteran survivors who help people in better days.
By the way, I'm Hakon.
You were a Night Runner. You used to help people, remember?
Night Runners are gone. Finished. A myth.
And although it's not entirely clear you can trust them, you need allies in the dark. These are the modern Dark Ages. It's been 15 years since the apocalypse, and the world has changed. The old civilization has fallen, but a new one has been built on its ashes. People fight desperately for scarce resources. The rules are broken, and weakness is punished.
She's innocent!
Three factions struggle for position in the city. Survivors pride themselves on being able to adapt to any circumstances and cobble together safe zones almost everywhere. Peacekeepers, loyal soldiers, who want to impose their version of law and order and trample all in their path. Renegades, ex-prisoners serving their ruthless colonel, seeking to become sole rulers of the city.
Where is Wolves? Make him talk.
Use these factions to reach your goal. Help or harm them to reshape the city to your liking. Just remember, each faction contains complex characters.
Nosy Parker, ain't ya? Got some kind of bad habit of yours?
So, will you follow cold calculation or your heart?
The Bazaar needs good people. Help us and you'll find a home here.
Some in the city offer no chance for an alliance. Bandits, outlaws, and common thugs live only to plunder and kill, plunging the streets into chaos. Yet, nightfall scares all of them equally. darkness changes the rules of the world. As the light fails, monsters crawl out of hiding to prey on the poor souls caught outside the safety of UV rays. Hordes of infected pour into the streets like decaying lava. The deadly spawn of 15 years of mutation and evolution. Exploit the city's verticality and flee to the roofs. Though even there, you are never safe from swift and deadly virals. Or even greater threat. Yet night brings opportunity as well. Nests rife with infected during the day now lie empty. To explore them, you must tread carefully. But those brave enough to face the terrors of the night can loot a jackpot. Luckily, you have all the tools you need to survive. Extraordinary parkour skills allow you to navigate even the most treacherous terrain. On the roofs, you can count on your parkour acrobatics to save your life. But often, you'll have to face your enemies head on. And then you have to be smart, resourceful, and determined. We've worked hard on the essence of our combat, making sure swinging a big, meaty weapon is fun, satisfying, and well executed. But even the most brutal fights can be tactical as well. You have multiple ways to hone your skills toward the gameplay style that suits you best. It's up to you if you focus mostly on mobility and parkour, or aggressive, blunt force combat, or a crafty approach where the tools you've created get the job done. Every ability you learn can be a game changer and possibly a new favorite move. Things move fast and quick in Dying Light 2. Each moment matters. Each move could mean triumph or defeat. Choose your actions and friends carefully. Everything you do in the city can reshape the gameplay environment, change the course of the narrative, and decide the fate of the city's residents. But most importantly, you decide your own fate as well.
You're about to turn.
Make sure to stay human.
All right. That's Dying Light 2. It's a lot of things added to the game. More weapons. I seen the brass knuckles. More ways to kill zombies. Probably like a bigger map. Graphics look good. I'm watching it. I beat Dying Light 1, and I had a very fun time with it. Dying Light 2 like is better. I feel it's gonna have more character in the story. It's gonna show like he's about to turn into a zombie. I wanna see how that goes. I wanna see storyline behind that. I'm getting day one. I'm gonna stream every game that you see on this video. I'm gonna stream it on YouTube. I'm gonna stream it on YouTube. Trying to put my YouTube up higher now. I'm playing different games, stuff like that. This Dying Light 2 is going to be a game that I stream fully from beginning to end. So, all right, yeah, one more game, for, and this is number 7, right? Back for Blood. Now, I played the demo. I played a demo. I think I played on PC. I don't know if it's on my channel, my YouTube channel, or I think I have it on my Twitch. I think it's on my Twitch. But like I said, I played a demo. Demo was fire. Nice. It was a little laggy, a little glitchy, but that's a beta. That was a demo. So we had demo beta. So you know they're gonna fix the bugs. I'm a big fan of Left 4 Dead. I got the Xbox, Xbox 360 and Left 4 Dead in green. One of my favorite co-op games. It reminded me also World at what's that? Was World at War? What's that? World at War? I think it's World at War. The zombie game. I think it's World at War. World War Z. That game super similar to Left 4 Dead and Back 4 Blood. So I like those type of games. Have friends and you can play on PC, Xbox, and PS5. So no matter what I get it at, because I know it on Xbox is gonna be free. So I don't know if I'm gonna get it on Xbox or Game Pass, or I buy the game and get it on PS5. So I don't know. Depends. And normally I can't talk to my friends. Say I'm on Xbox, I can't talk to my friends on PS4. They're not into Discord and stuff like that. Like going to in-game chat on the PS5 and stuff like that. I want them to get on Discord, but they're not having like one of them got Discord, but they don't use it. But this is gonna be a good game. I'm looking forward to it. I'm gonna get it December 7th, end of this year. 4 days before my birthday, 7th. So this is gonna be the last game. See, we're gonna watch the trailer, Back 4 Blood. Let's get it.
Surviving here, rebuilding.
Survive is not enough. We've got to fight.
No, we don't need to do anything.
All right, when was the last time you saw written in any numbers? All of my best friends like to join me and fuck up. And they talk about.
Mondays. Another day in paradise.
All right, that's Back 4 Blood. Like I said, I played the demo. I enjoyed the demo. It's going to be a good game. I'm also looking forward to it. I'm getting it. One thing I like about it, and I played the demo, where if the character you playing dies or you get killed, that person turns to a zombie and starts chasing after you, which is always fun. I love I said, you look at games like Payday, World War Z, stuff like that, or what's the other game? Zombie game. I forgot the name of it. Popular zombie game. But those games have a similar mechanics. I always enjoy those type of games. I have super fun playing them. Like I said, this is going to be a day one too. Always have fun, stuff like that. Yeah, that's 7 games out of 18. There's more first-person shooters videos coming. I think I'm going to do it tomorrow. Or I might finish recording later on tonight. And like I said, we're going to keep going. I just wanted to show y'all some of the games that I'm excited for. And I'm looking forward to all these games. This year, I'm going to be broke because a lot of fucking games. Yeah, I'm going to. All right, this is your boy, Versatile Reg. Kind of going. I've been streaming Call of Duty, some Halo. I stream some Guilty Gear. Just some games like that, and for now, until you know, other games come through. But this your boy Versatile Reg. Like, comment, subscribe. Happy boy girl. Let's get to 300 subs. I appreciate everybody that came through my YouTube. Everybody from commenting for my video about game controller for the PS5, that channel or that video keep growing day by day, and I really appreciate coming in. Whatever.